There's something on my mind that's in my heart written on my face. And it would behoove me and my soul if I did state my case. And so it's truth is...
When I left university, I only had one idea in mind. I wanted to be a member of parliament. Mad, deranged fool that I was. I very quickly got out of that, but I went straight to the House of Commons, and for 26 years I was very, very happy there, working for members of Parliament, latterly for my husband, despite my mother saying to me, "Christine, why don't you do something in your own right?" I take her point, and I do take her point, and I know possibly I've missed out because I didn't do something in my own right. But when you look at the number of political marriages that failed, I think actually I did make the right decision in working for my husband for nearly 15 years, because we're still together. He led the life of a battery hen. You know, I answered the phone, I opened his post, I kept his diary. If he had a mistress, I would have to tell him it was time to go and see her. And then I'd have to have rung up and said it's time to come home. He was one of the few MPs who'd have been in deep trouble if he hadn't had an affair with his secretary. Eat your heart out, John Prescott. What that man's going to do when he loses his looks, I don't know. He'll have to ask David Mellor. I know. But my life was completely mapped out. My husband, Neil Hamilton, he had the fifth safest Conservative seat in the country. It took some losing, but he did it. And we had no idea then. We were very, very happy to start with. Everything was wonderful. Life was mapped out. The very first thing that happened was he was elected in June 1983. January 1984, he hadn't been in place a year, when the BBC's flagship programme, Panorama, basically in a nutshell, said that he was a closet racist, Nazi, fascist, etc., etc., anti-Semite. He was Hitler without a moustache.
All I've been in-